Hello, welcome to my third lecture on painting in Tibet. In the previous two lectures, I have discussed about the popular culture, what is popular literature, the difference between popular literature and high literature or classical literature, the differentiation between the classics and the bestseller. I also discussed about what is popular culture, how the borderline between the popular culture and the culture for the selected classes is very murky, and how making this differentiation is very problematic. I've also discussed about what is the definition of a comics and how a comics differentiate itself with the graphic narratives, why graphic narratives are much more serious. I've given you already examples of various graphic narratives like William Eisner's Contract with God, Art Spiegelman's Mouse. I've also talked about texts like, for example, Marjane Satrapi's famous Iranian graphic novel, Persepolis. And I've also discussed about a brief history of the comics, how it has been evolved from Batman to Spider-Man to Superman, and how how comics emerged as a very important discourse in academia. Today I'll begin with the adventures of Tintin, which is a very important graphic narrative or very important graphic novel comics in the history of the European comics and Franco-Belgian comics. Now let us begin. Who is Tintin? How he is created? Let us begin our journey with Tintin. So this lecture will be basically an introduction to Hergé's eternal creation known as Tintin. So basically the adventures of Tintin is basically a series of 24 comic albums. It has been published serially in various magazines and specifically in Tintin magazine later on. So it's basically a collection of 24 graphic comic albums created by the famous Belgian cartoonist Georges Rémy. He is known as Georges Rémy, and later he is known as Hergé, and how this transformation happens we'll discuss later on. Actually, Georges Rémy signed his documents, signed his comics as R.G. George Rémy, Georges R.G., and later it has been transformed into hence Hergé. So the series was one of the most popular European comics of the 20th century. First, the series start appearing on 10th of January 1929 in Le Petit Vignettium, the Little 20th. It's basically a youth supplement to the Belgian newspaper Le Vignettium Cecile, the 20th century. So, the success of the series led to the serialized strips published in Belgium's leading newspaper later on in La Soir, the evening. And later it created the famous Tintin magazine. এতটাই জনপ্রিয় হয়ে পড়েছিল যে খবরের কাগজের পাতার মধ্যে আর টিনটিন কে রাখা যায়নি। পরবর্তীকালে ইট ট্রান্সফর্মড ইনটু আ টিনটিন ম্যাগাজিন এন্ড জর্জেস রেমি অ্যাকচুয়ালি বিকামস আ সুপারস্টার। হার্জি অ্যাকচুয়ালি বিকামস আ সুপারস্টারস অফ গ্রাফিক ন্যারেটিভ, আ সুপারস্টার অফ 20th সেঞ্চুরি কমিক্স। অ্যাজ আই অলরেডি সেড, টিনটিন ইজ রিয়েলি আ ক্যানন। টিনটিন নিজেই একটা ইন্ডাস্ট্রি, টিনটিন নিজেই একটা ইনস্টিটিউশন। If you go to Belgium or in any part of the Belgium, you'll find there are various grocery shops dedicated to Tintin. There are various shops dedicated to school bags, to school bottles dedicated to Tintin. There are amusement parks dedicated to Tintin, roads named after various characters of the Hergé comics, metro stations named after Tintin. বুঝতেই পারছো রাস্তার নাম টিনটিন। আমাদের এখানে রাস্তা হয় বিভিন্ন বিখ্যাত মনীষীর নামে, ওখানে টিনটিনের নামে রাস্তা হয়। তাহলে বুঝতেই পারছো এতটা ফেমাস ক্যানোনিক্যাল একটা গ্রাফিক ক্যারেক্টার যে নিজেই একটা ইনস্টিটিউশন, নিজেই একটা ইন্ডাস্ট্রিতে পরিণত হয়েছে। হি ইজ ভেরি পপুলার, এক্সট্রিমলি পপুলার। এই টিনটিন কমিক্সের একটা অত্যন্ত পপুলার কিছুটা ডিফারেন্ট একটা গ্রাফিক টেক্সট তোমাদের পড়তে হবে, অ্যান্ড দ্যাট ইজ দ্য টিনটিন ইন টিবেট। দিস ইজ আ ভেরি পার্সোনাল টেক্সট অফ হারজে, ইট ইট কন্টেন্স আ পার্সোনাল মেমোয়ার অফ হারজে, বিকজ পারহ্যাপস দিস টেক্সট অ্যাকচুয়ালি কন্টেন্স ডকুমেন্টেশন অফ আ ভেরি ডিস্টার্বিং পিরিয়ড অফ হারজেস লাইফ। সো the success of this particular series later transformed into Tintin magazine, and in 1950 Harje created the studio Harje, which produced the canonical versions of the 11 Tintin albums. And by 2007, almost a century after the Harje's birth, Georges Remy, born on 1907, Tintin had been published in more than 70 languages. Can you believe Tintin has been translated into 70 languages, including Bengali? আমরা জানি টিনটিন বাংলায় ট্রান্সলেট করেছেন নীরেন্দ্রনাথ চক্রবর্তী, এবং আনন্দ পাবলিশার সেটাকে পাবলিশ করেছে, মালয়ালম, কেরলের ভাষা, হিন্দি, এমন কোন ভাষা নেই যেখানে টিনটিন প্রায় অনুদিত হয়নি। উইথ সেলস মোর দ্যান 200 মিলিয়ন কপিস, and had been adapted for radio, television, theater, film. You must see the film made by Spielberg, by Spielberg, and it's a great film on the adventures of Tintin. Basically, it's a merging of the three stories of Tintin, but again, it's a great movie. You must see. So now, let us have a look into Georges Prosper Remy, the creator of Tintin Comics. Georges Prosper Remy, from 1907 to 1983, known by the pen name Harje, he was a Belgian cartoonist. So, the creator of Tintin is Georges Prosper Remy. You can see him here. And the series of the, he is the creator of the series of the comic albums known as Tintin, which is considered as one of the most popular European comics of the 20th century. He is also responsible for the creation of the other various comic albums like Quick and Fluke, The Adventures of Joe, Jet and Jocko. This is basically an adventure of the two adolescent girl and a boy with a monkey. I have read this adventure stories on the pages of Anandamela in my childhood days. And his works were executed in his distinct ligne claire drawing style. What is ligne claire, or clear line drawing style? I'll discuss it later on. It's basically a very clear way, a very defining way of creating a form of painting is known as the ligne claire. This is a ligne claire drawing style, but you can see clear borders. There is a clear border making of this drum. Clear border of all these characters, their suits, their costumes. So this is a ligne claire drawing style. So with clear line drawing style, he painted Tintin. With Raymond Leblanc, he established Tintin magazine in 1946, through which he serialized new adventures of Tintin stories. As the magazine's artistic director, he also oversaw the publication of other successful comic series such as Edgar P. Jacobs' Blake and the Mortimer. In 1950, he established Studios Harje as a team to aid him in his ongoing project. So later Harje created his team, and a prominent member of this team includes Jacques Martin and Bob D. Moore, who greatly contributed to the subsequent volumes of the Adventures of Tintin. So amid various personal turmoil following the collapse of his first marriage, he produced Tintin in Tibet. It's his personal favorite of his works, and in later years he became less prolific and unsuccessfully attempted to establish himself as an abstract artist. So this ligne claire artist, later trying to establish himself as an abstract expressionist later on in his career as an abstract painter, but he was not very successful. He remained successful, Georges Prosper Remy remained successful because of his creation of Tintin album, and particularly for the adventures of Joe, JT and Jocko. The series has been admired for its clean, expressive drawing style, and as I've said, that it is known as Harje's Ligne-clear drawing style. It is well-researched plots, straddle a variety on the genres, swashbuckling adventures with elements of fantasy, mysteries, political thrillers. So there is, of course, fantasy, mystery, elements of political thriller, rajnoitik bhabe je somosto suspenseful story hoy shegulo tinder er moddhe ache. Science fiction, of course, Tintin in the Destination Moon, Tintin in Moon is of course a science fiction. The stories feature slapstick humor offset by the dashes of the sophisticated satire and political and cultural commentary. So Tintin is not only a graphic text, it is not only a graphic album, it's basically full of cultural and political commentary. Graphic narrative এর এই দিকটাই যে political এবং cultural commentary role serve করা, এই দিকটাতে আমি তোমাদের প্রত্যেকের attention seek করার চেষ্টা করছি। তোমরা যখন কোনো একটা text কে পড়বে, as I already told in my sixth semester classes, that that it is no more a literary artifact. Previously in the 1950s and 60s, a particular literary creation is known as a novel, a poem, or a literary artifact in general. But now on, it is basically a text. A text means it is open-ended domain for interpretation. It's basically an open-ended invitation for the readers to interpret the text in your own way. The death of the author is the corollary to the birth of the reader. এই যে অথরের ডেথ হচ্ছে লেখার মধ্যে দিয়ে, অথরের মৃত্যু হচ্ছে তারপরেই জন্ম হচ্ছে পাঠকে। তোমরা একটা টেক্সটকে কেমন করে দেখবে সেটা তোমাদের হাতে। ফলে টিনটিন ইজ নো মোর আ চাইল্ডস ন্যারেটিভ, ইটস নো মোর অ্যান কমিক্স ডেডিকেটেড ফর দ্য অ্যাডোলেসেন্ট পিপল। ইট বেসিক্যালি বিকামস আ ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট sophisticated satire and a domain of political and cultural commentary. It contains the elements of myth, fantasy, mysteries, political thriller, science fiction, everything. তোমাদের honor standard এ যে কোনো text যখন recommend করা হয় এটা মাথায় রাখা হয় একটা text এর multiple layer রয়েছে, there should be multiple layers of a text and it is up to you how you are interpreting the text. So for this honors level, Tintin no more an adolescent adventurous narrative for you. It is it will be for you a very important text to unravel the political and social satire of the contemporary times. Jodio in the Tintin in Tibet, it's a very personal text. It's a it's basically a traumatic, it's basically a container of the traumatic neurosis, traumatic happenings in the life of the author. But again, of course, there are various important social and political allusions residing in the Tintin in Tibet. But now let us discuss about the style through which this this Tintin in Tibet is created. This particular style is known as the Ligne-Claire drawing style. So basically Ligne-Claire in French, it's basically means clear line. It's a style of drawing pioneered by Hergé, the Belgian creator of the Adventures of Tintin. I already told you it uses clear strong lines, all of the same white and no hatching, while contrast is downplayed as well and cast shadows are often illumined. So basically Ligne-Claire is the clear line drawing style where there is clear line border of the characters and where the contrast is actually downplayed. There is no such great play of the light and the shadow, but rather it's a clear line drawing style. And additionally, the style often features with strong colors and combination of the cartoonish characters. They have strong color, basically RGB, red, green, and blue. A color dominate kore, yellow onek khetre dominate kore. The strong color, shegulo ei somosto drawing style e beshilo khetrei dominate kore. And it's basically a combination of the cartoonish characters against a very realistic background. And all these elements together can result in giving comics drawn in this way, a flat aspect. অনেক কি বলে যে এই ধরনের কমিক্স অনেক flat aspect create করে. The name was first created by Just Suwate in 1977. So Hargreaves is the propounder of this Ligne Claire drawing style. Now I will discuss about the publication date of Tintin. Tintin is a, as I already told you, it's a serialized graphic narrative which started its publication from 1929 and ended through the death of Georges Remy in 1976. So this series first appeared in French on 10th of January 1929, I already told you, in Le Petit Vignettier, the Little 20th. It's a youth supplement to the Belgian newspaper Le Vignettier Cecile, the 20th century. The success of the series saw a serialized publication in Belgium's leading newspaper La Soir, later created, Hargreaves created Studios Hargreaves, which produced the canonical versions of the 10 Tintin albums. It's basically a team creation. The series is set during a largely realistic 20th century background. The hero is Tintin. Who is Tintin? Tintin is a courageous young Belgian reporter. Tintin is basically a reporter, Shangmadi. And at the same time, he is adventurer. Tintiner Shangmadik Shotta, the reporter identity, khub kom shomoy revealed hoyeche. Revealed hoyeche Tintin in Soviet, the land of the Soviets, revealed in Tintin in Congo, in the first two graphic narratives, very controversial graphic narratives, known as anti-Soviet doctrine and known as very racial narrative, anti-black narrative, Tintin in Congo. এই দুটোকে অত্যন্ত কন্ট্রোভার্সিয়াল টিনটিন টেক্সট বলে ধরা হয়। পরবর্তীকালে টিনটিন টেক্সট অনেক চেঞ্জ হয়েছে, অনেক মাল্টি লেয়ার্ড হয়েছে। আমি সেই পলিটিক্যাল অ্যাসপেক্টও টিনটিনের ডিসকাস করব একটু পরে। বাট বেসিক্যালি হি ইজ আ রিপোর্টার অ্যান অ্যাডভেঞ্চারার এইডেড বাই হিজ ফেথফুল ডগ স্নোই, বাংলায় যাকে বলে কুট্টুস, ইন ফ্রেঞ্চ হি ইজ নোন অ্যাজ মিলাও। অ্যান্ড আদার প্রোটাগনিস্টস ইনক্লুড ব্র্যাশ অ্যান্ড দ্য সিনিক্যাল মিস্টার ক্যাপ্টেন হ্যারপ, the famous character famous for his slang languages, for the blistering blue barnacles, and the intelligent but hearing impaired Professor Calculus, Professor Cuthbert Calculus. These all characters are serialized characters, they are rather flat characters, by aki rokom bhabe roye geche, jodio there is a great change in Captain Haddock's nature. Professor Cuthbert Calculus, Captain Haddock, and Tintin. Tintin is a reporter, Captain Haddock is a retired sailor, and Professor Cuthbert Calculus is a scientist. In French, he is known as Professor Tournesol. As well as incompetent, stupid detectives, Thompson and Thompson, Bangla Johnson and Ronson, bole ederke, eta incompetent, stupid detective, they are basically twins. In French, they are known as Dupont et Dupont. And there is also an opera diva, opera singer, Bianca Castafio. She appeared in some of the Tintin comic albums. But Captain Haddock, Professor Calculus, Cuthbert Calculus, Thompson and Thompson, Tintin and Snowy is a constant presence in the in various comic albums of Tintin. So let us begin with the political journey of Tintin. Hargreaves was employed as an illustrator in this daily, the 20th century, La Vignettier Cecile. It's a staunchly Roman Catholic and conservative Belgian newspaper based in Hargreaves' native Brussels, run by Abbé Norbert Wallis. Abbé Norbert Wallis was a very conservative Catholic, and the paper described itself as a Catholic newspaper for doctrine and information. As you all know that Christian religion has many denominations. The two major most important denomination is Catholic and Protestant. I will discuss later on about these religious background. I'm not going into details, but Catholicism is basically a conservative and classical religious school, while Protestantism is a deviation from Catholicism. And this particular newspaper basically disseminated a far-right fascist viewpoint, and basically it is against all form of communist ideology, and well is appointed Haje as the editor of a new Thursday supplement titled La Petite Vignettium, the Little 20th, propagating Wiles's socio-political views to its young readership. The comics contained explicitly pro-fascist and anti-Semitic sentiment. So basically, Tintin begins its journey as an anti-Semitic text, as a text against the Jews, as an anti-communist text, text against the Soviet Russia, and it's a basically a pro-fascist comic album. যেখানে অটোক্রাসির পক্ষে কথা বলা হয়, ফ্যাসিস্টদের পক্ষে কথা বলা হয়, মানে বুঝতেই পারছো হার্জের পলিটিক্যাল ব্যাকগ্রাউন্ড কি সেটা এখানে ইম্পর্টেন্ট ডিসকাশন না হলেও হার্জের বিগিনিং অ্যাজ আ জার্নি অ্যাজ আ অ্যাজ আ পলিটিক্যাল অ্যাজ এ গ্রাফিক ন্যারেটিভ ইট বিগিনস উইথ ক্রিয়েটিং এ পলিটিক্যাল প্রোপাগান্ডা মেশিন বেসিক্যালি আ পলিটিক্যাল গ্রাফিক ন্যারেটিভ এই ক্রিয়েশনের থ্রু দিয়ে কিন্তু হার্জের শুরু হচ্ছে ক্যারিয়ার তিনি চান বা না চান বিকজ অফ দিস ম্যান নোন অ্যাজ অ্যাবে নরমাট ওয়ালিস অলদো হার্জে ওয়ান্টেড টু সেন্ড টিনটিন টু দ্য ইউনাইটেড স্টেটস ইন হিজ ভেরি ফার্স্ট কমিক অ্যালবাম বাট ওয়ালিস অর্ডার্ড হিম টু সেট হিজ অ্যাডভেঞ্চার ইন দ্য সোভিয়েত ইউনিয়ন লেটার টিনটিন উইল ভিজিট আমেরিকা লেটার অন বাট ওয়ালিস অর্ডার্ড হিম টু সেট হিজ অ্যাডভেঞ্চার ইন দ্য সোভিয়েত ইউনিয়ন acting as an anti-socialist propaganda for children. So, বুঝতেই পারছো ছোটদের মগজ ধোলাইয়ের উপায় হিসেবে কিন্তু প্রথম টিনটিনকে ইন্ট্রোডিউস করা হয় in order to brainwash little children. So, from the very beginning, Tintin becomes a very important political text. And the result is Tintin in the Land of the Soviets. At Wiles's direction in June, he began serialization of the second story known as Tintin in Congo. Again, it is designed to encourage colonial sentiment towards the Belgian Congo. Belgian Congo is that province where the Belgian people, the people of the French, the colony, they have created a project of vigorous torture, great rampages and outrageous colonial adventure. Generally, বলা হয় যে বেলজিয়ান কঙ্গো ইজ মাচ মোর ওয়ার্স কলোনিয়াল সেটেলমেন্ট দ্যান ইন্ডিয়া ব্রিটিশরা ভারতীয়দের উপর যতটা অত্যাচার করেছে বেলজিয়ান কঙ্গোতে অনেক বেশি অত্যাচার করা হয়েছে সো দিস পার্টিকুলার গ্রাফিক ন্যারেটিভ বিকামস অ্যাকচুয়ালি আ পলিটিক্যাল টুল ফর দিস অ্যাবে নরবার্ট ওয়ালিস হু ওয়াজ a Christian Catholic who was a pro-fascist and anti-communist propagator of various news. An author in a very paternalistic style that depicted the Congolese as childlike idiots. There are various stereotypical characters in Congo. The Congo people have been described as evil. The black colored people have been described as bad. So, and in later decades, it was accused of racism. But at the same time, at the time when Tintin was published, it was uncontroversial and very popular. And various publicity stunts were introduced in order to increase the sale of the Tintin. So this is the beginning of the Tintin, with the publication of the Tintin in the Land of the Soviets and Tintin in the Congo, the second part. So these two graphic narratives, Tintin in the Land of the Soviets and Tintin in the Congo, they contain actually various stereotypical characters, they contain various biased and prejudiced viewpoints of the author, like racism, like anti-communism. So Tintin from the very beginning becomes a very important political and politico-satirical commentary on the contemporary times. So the adventures of Tintin in the Land of the Soviets, what is the socio-political background? Of course, the Bolshevik Revolution of 1917, the founding of the Soviet Union in 1922, Soviet Union becomes a socialist country. That is, the means of the production and the forces of the production became public. So for the first time, Soviet Union become a socialist country where all the production tools, be it land, labor, capital, or organization, become the property of the general public. And in the Tintin in the Land of the Soviet, which published in 1930, it actually shows that it's basically a story of lies, a falsification created by the Soviet people, that Soviet Russia is basically an oppressive and suppressive and corruptive country, and the communism is basically a kind of hypocrisy. The story was thus inherently and intentionally biased against the Bolshevik government to instill anti-Marxist and anti-socialist ideas into the children. For example, examples like Bolsheviks, the re-elections, elections is shohay, Tintin ukhane gache, as a reporter, ebong dekhche kibhabe Bolshevik the election ke re-korche, the government steals people's grains, government lokjoner প্রচুর ফসল চুরি করছে সেইটা সোভিয়েত রাষ্ট্রে কিভাবে হচ্ছে দেখানো হয়েছে দেয়ার ইজ অ্যান এক্সাম্পল কমরেডস ইউ হ্যাভ থ্রি লিস্টস বিফোর ইউ দ্য ফার্স্ট ইজ দ্যাট অফ দ্য কমিউনিস্ট পার্টি অল দোজ হু অপোজ দ্য লিস্ট রেজ দেয়ার হ্যান্ডস নাও হু সেজ নো টু দিস লিস্ট হাতে বন্দুক হাতে দাঁড়িয়ে রয়েছে যদি কেউ অপোজ করে কেউ অপোজ করছে না যে নোবডি Then I declare the Communist Party listed, elected unanimously. I declare Communist Party as the winner of this election, and they will eventually form the government. So through this particular comic panel, Harje is trying to reveal the hypocrisy of the Communist Russia. Though I don't know really, we always don't know that what is the historical truth. Anekei bole the Communist Russia. Is of course a tale of oppression, suppression, and corruption. Many communist historians also said that no, it is not fully true. But Tintin, through his political baggage in 1929-1930, depicted communist Russia through this particular fascist lens. Samajani, fascism and communism, ake oporer poripunti dui shotru. Pro-fascist at a standpoint, a particular comic context, a particular graphic narrative context, Tintin Nietzsche. We'll move into our second text known as Racism, known as Tintin in Congo. And we can of course see racism and animal cruelty depicted in Tintin in Congo. This is the first Tintin comic album created in color mode. The first one, the Tintin in the Land of the Soviets, is a black and white comic album. So Congo was basically a Belgian colony, as you all know, from 1908 to 1960. And Tintin in Congo was originally meant to educate young Belgians about their country's colonial regime. So Harje's most controversial story, it contains, of course, racism. That is depiction of the African natives as subhuman creatures, as monkey people. Tara manush noy, kalo mani manush noy. Color narratives create kora hoyeche. Ek dhoroner ethno-political discrimination create kora hoyeche. Ethnocentrism create kora hoyeche. And of course there is depiction of the animal cruelty. Tintin himself kills animals wantonly. Chimpanzees, antelope, and even he actually blows up a rhinoceros with dynamite. So it's a terrible and formidable tale of animal cruelty. It is, of course, an immature and ill-researched story. Later on, we can see for example, in Harje's Tintin in Tibet, it's a very well-researched story. But this is an ill-researched story when compared to the later ones. You can see, of course, the similarity of the Tintin carrying by the black natives, and another famous colonial painting, the Shaheen, is being carried by the black men. So Tintin at kintu Tintin thakche na, Tintin kintu ekta shudhumatro ekta bachchader jonno graphic novel ba bachchader jonno ekta comic album e transformed thakche na. Eta ekta important political ebong social narrative ebong commentary te transformed hocche, but it tells the story of the racism and animal cruelty. Can see the evidence of the racism and animal cruelty in Tintin, for example. This is a great example of Tintin bearing a hole, testing the dynamite, and he is completely blowing off the rhinoceros. Here, in this particular text, you can see that a conversation of Tintin with Coco. So that's agreed, Coco. You will accompany me throughout my journey in Congo. Yes, master. And Snowy is commenting that he doesn't look very bright. So a particular person is being judged on the basis of his own skin color. The guy ronger opore judge kora hocche. So to start with, I need a monkey from the same family as the first one. Bang! He's killing the monkey. And he's killing the elephant. No noise. There he is. Don't we like the scenes of the bloodshed? I don't like the scenes of the bloodshed, said Snowy. There is no bloodshed. And hence, with bang, it ends like the elephant. And at dawn, Tintin sets off for the mission, having first removed the precious elephant tusks. So, Hathir Dant niye Tintin beriye pore ekta bhoyongkor scenery bujhtei parcho kintu racism among animal killings in Congo dekhano hoyeche. Tintin in America is a great deviation, or rather, it differentiates itself from the first two Tintin comic albums. For the first time, Tintin in America becomes a very masterpiece of satire. Tintin, for the first time, he mocks the American capitalism. American dhonotantra, American pujibad ke bhayankar bhabe Tintin criticize korlo. It's basically the story of finding an oil field in the Red Indian country, the gangster syndicate in Chicago, widespread mechanization of the industries. Eiter critique porinoto holo Tintin in America. So you can see this is office of the police, and police school likha diya hocche GSE. GSE means Gangsters Syndicate of Chicago. This is another important graphic panel where the politics of the contemporary oil filled mercenaries in America has been totally exposed, and you can see a tremendous critique of the capitalism in Tintin in America. You see this huge machine. Here is how it works. The cattle go in here on a conveyor belt, nose to tail, conveyor belt and the cattle dhuke jacche, and he has been transformed, that cattle, a goat transformed hocche, and come out the other end as the cornered beef or sausages for cooking, fat and whatever. It's completely automatic. It's an automatization of the industry, a America te, American capitalism, তার ক্রিটিক আমরা টিনটিন ইন আমেরিকাতে দেখতে পাচ্ছি। টিনটিন আরো বেশি ম্যাচিউর হচ্ছে 1934-1935। টিনটিন বিগান ইটস জার্নি ইন 1929-1930। এখন 1934-1935 আমরা রয়েছি। টিনটিন দ্য ব্লু লোটাস, দ্য ব্লু লোটাস বাংলাতে নীল কমল বলা হয়। ইটস বেসিক্যালি ওয়ান অফ দ্য হার্টেস্ট ইমোর্টাল ওয়ার্কস হুইচ অ্যাকচুয়ালি চেঞ্জ দ্য টিনটিন গ্রাফিক ন্যারেটিভ। It's basically has its own historical accuracy. It's basically the setting is in Japan, and Japanese invasion of Manchuria is the the setting is actually China. Sorry, I'm extremely sorry. The Japanese invasion of Manchuria is a very important topic here, and the League of Nations trials and tribulations becomes a very important topic in Blue Lotus. In Blue Lotus, Tintin shows how the criminal activities of the Chinese people. But of course, Tintin takes a stand against the Asian stereotypes. So this is an example where various criminal people are being engaged into blowing out of the railway tracks and other things. And he is saying that, and once again, Japan has fulfilled her mission as guardian of law and civilization in the Far East. So here is a critique of the Japanese imperialism. If we have been forced to our utmost regret to send troops into China, it is for the good of the China herself. China bhalo jonno amra China the shuno shobdo pathab. Japan must never forget her duty as the guardian of law and civilization in the Far East. So Tintin here emerged as a critique of the colonialism. Tintin, for the first time here, is emerged as a critic of the Japanese colonization, hegemonization of the Japan. though in the first two texts Tintin propounded colonization, but in this text Tintin is critiquing that colonization. Samalochona korche. I am authorized to announce that my government has ordered its troops to withdraw from Chinese territories occupied after the incident on the Shanghai-Nanking Railway. To that, gentlemen, I must add with regret that in solemn protest against the affront to my country, Japan finds herself obliged to resign from the League of the Nations. So, age of puro politics to Japanese invasion of the Manchuria, targeting to take it, you can see. The very well researched narrative came from Japan. Prisoner the Niga Hoto, the contemporary Japanese cities, Tintin depicted. You can see. In the broken year, Kan Bhanga Murti Bangla, we can see, of course, politics in the South America. The broken year hardly creates actually two fictitious countries to draw parallels with his story in South American politics, Sam Theodorus, basically it is historically similar to Bolivia or Argentina. Hey, Sam Theodorus ke amra baje bare 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 dekhte pabo Tintiner nana dhoroner porobortikale graphic narrative version. So Sam Theodorus is basically a satirical version of a South American nation under the yoke of the military dictatorship. So Tintin provides a great critique of the dictatorship, military dictatorship of the South America through its graphic narrative, and historically similar to Bolivia and Argentina. So the Grand Chapo War, the minor character of the Basil Bazarov and his equivalent in real story, Basil Zaharov. We can see all these well-researched political narratives. Balkan narratives, 1938-39, Tintin deal korche Sildavia, মানে বেসিক্যালি ট্রান্সিলভানিয়া এবং মলদাভিয়া এবং বর্দুরিয়া বর্দুরিয়া এবং সিলদাভিয়ার যে লড়াই তাই নিয়ে টিনটিন ডিল করছে কিং ওটাকার সেক্টর ওটাকারের রাজদণ্ড ইটস আ গ্রেট পলিটিক্যাল মাস্টারপিস স্টানিং প্যারালালস টু দ্য বলকান পলিটিক্স লিডিং টু দ্য ওয়ার্ল্ড ওয়ার সেকেন্ড সিলদাভিয়া ইকুয়ালস টু পারহ্যাপস ট্রান্সিলভানিয়া অর মলদাভিয়া এন্ড বর্দুরিয়া ইজ আ টিপিক্যাল ইস্টার্ন ব্লক নেশন আন্ডার আ টোটালিটেরিয়ান ফ্যাসিস্ট গভর্নমেন্ট আমরা জানি যে রোমানিয়া যুগোস্লোভিয়া স্লোভাকিয়া যেগুলো হাঙ্গেরি যেগুলো প্রত্যেকটাই ছিল সোভিয়েত ইউনিয়নের পার্ট তো এর টিপিক্যাল একটা বর্দুরিয়া ইজ আ টিপিক্যাল ইস্টার্ন সোভিয়েত ব্লক নেশন তাকে সেই হিসেবে ডিসক্রাইব করা হচ্ছে তিনটিকে এবং স্টিল দ্য স্টিল গার্ড ইন দ্য রোমানিয়ান আয়রন গার্ড আমাদেরকে মনে করাচ্ছে সেই সময়কার যে ইস্টার্ন ভেরিয়াস ইস্টার্ন ইউরোপের যে বিভিন্ন নেশনের যে ক্রাইসিস সেইটা এই বলকান পলিটিক্সটাকে ক্লিয়ারলি রিমাইন্ড করাচ্ছে দেন সেকেন্ড ওয়ার্ল্ড ওয়ার অকার্ড বেলজিয়াম হ্যাড বিন অ্যানেক্সড বাই দ্য নাজিস হাজে ওয়াজ নাও ওয়ার্কিং ফর দ্য লাস্ট ওয়ার আ প্রোজ নাজি নিউজ পেপার অ্যান্ড সাটল রেফারেন্সেস টু দ্য ওয়ার্ল্ড ওয়ার ইন দ্য আর্লিয়েস্ট অর দ্য in the land of the black gold and anti-Semitism of the Nazi can be clearly found, be detected in the shooting star, Tintin and the shooting star, Tintin in America. After the Second World War, I mean, there was a radical change, Tintin and Mothe, space race. After the Second World War, Tintin transformed itself into a science fiction. Two narratives of Tintin, Destination Moon and Tintin in Moon. All these two narratives, the Calculus Affair and the Destination Moon, all these things actually appeared as a projection of the space race between the USSR and the USA. This conflict in the space race, ke aage ye jabe mohakash goboshona, that inspires the epic two-part lunar landing adventure. Sildavia's secretive atomic research center এবং বর্ডুরিয়াস অ্যাটমিক সু স্যাবটেজ দিস অ্যাটমিক রিসার্চ সেন্টার এইটা এই টিনটিন ইন ডেস্টিনেশন মুন অ্যান্ড টিনটিন ইন দ্য ল্যান্ড অফ দ্য মুন এবং পরবর্তীকালে ক্যালকুলাস অ্যাফেয়ারে যেখানে আমরা কোল্ড ওয়ার দেখতে পাচ্ছি বিটুইন সিলদাভিয়া অ্যান্ড বর্ডুরিয়া রিমেম্বার সিলদাভিয়া অ্যান্ড বর্ডুরিয়া উইল এসেন্সিয়ালি ইমার্জ অ্যাজ আ ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট পলিটিক্যালি কনফ্লিক্টিং নেশনস ইন টিনটিনস ন্যারেটিভ সো Calculus Affair is a very political thriller and it shows that how Professor Calculus is being kidnapped in this particular narrative in order to create a hydrogen bomb, an atomic power. destroy everything. So Professor Kepler's visit to the Geneva was possibly inspired by CERN. And this gentleman is declaring that our high command has created a great atomic power, and he is showing that how it will eventually destroy all these cities. Tintin changed a lot in the 1940s. In the Red Sea Sargs, we can see, of course, the rampant slave trading of the in the Red Sea by the Arabs. The Red Sea Sharks is a logical sequel to the Land of the Black Bolt. Kalo Shonar Deshwar sequel chilo Red Sea Shark. Ebong amra dekhte pai je Arabian der Tintin ke rokom kore onek khetrei humanitarian stand Arabian der dekhano hoyeche, jeta age African native er khetre Tintin dekhayni. So perhaps is this Hodges' way for making up for the controversies in the Congo? Congo te je ghotona ghoteche je je jinish gulo dekhiyechilo Hodges, সেগুলো কি মেক আপ করার জন্য টিনটিনের ন্যারেটিভে এই যে হিউম্যানিটেরিয়ান স্ট্যান্ড পয়েন্ট রিগার্ডিং দ্য অ্যারাবস এগুলোকে দেখাচ্ছে? দিস ইজ ক্যাপ্টেন হ্যানক সেইং ইউ ট্রাফিক ইয়ার ইন হিউম্যান ফ্লেশ, ইউ ডিজার্ভ টু বি স্ট্রাং আপ অন দ্য মিজেন ইয়ার ট্রাউ. সো ইউ ক্যান সি দ্য ক্যারেক্টার অফ ক্যাপ্টেন হ্যানক, ভেরি হিউমারাস ক্যারেক্টার, অ্যাট দ্য সেম টাইম a very important character, because through this character Tintin not only provides Harji not only provides a slapstick humor, but also Captain Haddock is a lifetime friend of Tintin. So Captain Haddock is actually a symbol, an allegory of friendship, token of friendship, an iconography of friendship in Tintin. This is some of the imageries in the crab with the golden claws. Tintin in the 1960s changed a lot. Now Tintin highlighted on the politics of the media. The rise of the paparazzi culture forms the backdrop of the Castafiore Emerald, and politics behind the various rival media houses shows also the ill-treatment of the gypsies. In 1975-76, Tintin and the Picaros, it's actually Hodges' last complete story. It's a political masterpiece. It's again a conflict between the San Theodores and the other country. It's a political satire against the Banana Republic. Because the revolution here is sponsored by the International Banana Company. And it shows the oppressive military dictatorship of South America. Human rights are kothay keno bola hoyeche. Tintin insists that the revolution be completely non-violent and bloodless. Here is a conversation where the general Alcazar is saying that, but at least you will let me shoot Tapioca and his ministers and his staff officers. You wouldn't refuse me that. You won't shoot anyone, General. Which is no one but Tapioca and his ministers then. But I said no one. You can take it or leave it. We can't shoot for the matter. So Tintin is talking about a bloodless revolution. So at least let me shoot Tapioca, just Tapioca. I implore you, no, no one. I'll cure your Picaros of their drunkenness, and you will promise me not to use any violence while I am helping you to regain power. Which I will cure your revolutionary friends of the drunkenness. Tara shobai intoxicated by oshustho hoye porechilo. Taderke jagabe Tintin ek dhoroner chemical diye. এবং একটা ব্লাড রেভলিউশনের কথা তাকে প্রমিস করতে হবে আলকিসার। সো বুঝতেই পারছো টিনটিন এখানে কিন্তু অনেক ম্যাচিওর টেক্সট হিসেবে ইমার্জ করছে। সো দিস ইজ অল দ্য কমিক অ্যালবামস অফ টিনটিন, লিস্ট অফ দ্য টিনটিন কমিক অ্যালবামস, অ্যাডভেঞ্চার অফ দ্য টিনটিন ইন দ্য ল্যান্ড অফ দ্য সোভিয়েটস, স্টার্ট উইথ দিস, দেন টিনটিন ইন আমেরিকা, সিগারস অফ ফ্যারাও, দ্য ব্লু লোটাস, দ্য ব্রোকেন ইয়ার্ড, দ্য ব্ল্যাক আইল্যান্ড, কৃষ্ণদ্বীপের রহস্য, Seven Crystal Balls, Red Sea Sharks. You have to read this. This is recommended in your syllabus. Tintin in Tibet. So, Tintin is basically an ideal comic book hero. As we all know that Sutton Fringe Law of 1949 banned all children's literature that showed cowardice and ignominy in favorable light. So probably why Tintin was shown to be noble, courageous, dignified, like an overgrown boy scout. And Georges Remy was himself a boy scout. Boy scouted near about equivalent to NSS. That through the বিভিন্ন মানুষজনকে help করে একটা institution. So Georges Remy was himself a boy scout. তার boy scout ethics অনেক ক্ষেত্রেই টিনটিনের মধ্যে দিয়ে এক ধরনের একটা সিম্পল এথিক্যাল কোড ক্রিয়েশনের দিকে নিয়ে গেছে and Tintin hence becomes an ideal comic book hero. Batman is not an ideal comic book hero. There are various shades of the light and the darkness in Batman. Evil and goodness even in Superman. Krypton উপগ্রহ থেকে এসেছেন সুপারম্যান তার মধ্যে অনেক খারাপ দিক রয়েছে কিন্তু টিনটিনের মধ্যে কোনো খারাপ দিক নেই ফলে এই যে আইডিয়াল বয় স্কাউট এথিক্স অপারেটেড হয়েছে হার্জের মাইন্ডের মধ্যে উই ক্যান সি অফকোর্স various influence of the human rights movement in Tintin. It's an overgrown boy scout in pursuit of a simple ethical code. But what is ethics? Ethics is basically, ethics shouldn't be equated with morality. Ethics is a universal code of axiology. It's an universal value added system. It's basically a value, universal value system. Manusher mullabodh shekha. Morality, Indian morality can differ from the American morality. American morality can differ from the Bengal 19th century morality. Morality depends on the time frame. Shomoyer upore morality depend kore. 1890s er Indian morality, 2020 Indian morality is completely different. But ethics is something universal. Ethics is something eternal. Ethics is something much more less ephemeral. Ethics is an axiological standpoint. So, early stories created many controversies like animal cruelty, racism, anti-Semitism. But later, Tintin is completely different, as I showed you, that it talks about a bloodless revolution, it talks about against the slave trading, it talks about stereotypical representations of the Arabs. So, Tintin and human rights are very problematic. Topic because in the earlier stories we can see animal cruelty, racism, anti-Semitism. In the later stories we can find talking about the non-violence, bloodless revolution, slave trading, etc. So, in this particular lecture, I have introduced you with the character of Tintin, with the evolution of the character of Tintin, and how politics and social commentary serves as a very important tool in Tintin comic album, a very important operational procedure in Tintin comics. So Tintin is not a narrative for the adolescent only. It's also a very culturally, socially and politically loaded narrative. এর মধ্যে রাজনৈতিক, অর্থনৈতিক, সামাজিক এবং সাংস্কৃতিক একটা ভয়ঙ্কর প্রভাব রয়েছে তোমাদেরকে সেইভাবেই টিনটিনকে ইন্টারপ্রেট করতে হবে বিকজ ফর দ্য আন্ডারগ্রাজুয়েট স্টুডেন্টস টিনটিন আর শুধুমাত্র অ্যাডোলেসেন্ট কমিক অ্যাডভেঞ্চার স্টোরি নয় ইটস আ স্টোরি হুইচ টকস অ্যাবাউট ফ্যাসিজম ইটস আ স্টোরি হুইচ টকস অ্যাবাউট অ্যান্টি কমিউনিজম ইটস বেসিক্যালি আ ন্যারেটিভ হুইচ টকস অ্যাবাউট পলিটিক্স ইন সাউথ আমেরিকা bloodless revolution, it talks about political insurgencies in the Far East, it talks about the critique of the capitalism in America. So Tintin becomes a very complex narrative. Through this particular lecture, I have tried to show you that how Tintin emerged as a very complex graphic narrative. Thank you. In the next lecture, I will introduce you with the various Tintin characters like Professor Cuthbert Calculus, like Captain Haddock and others. See you on the in the next lecture. Thank you. Bye.